Times of Bengal, where Bengal theme first up in the world.
We, the global network of Don Bosco Society, spread out over 132 countries, have only that as our goal in all our institutions: to give the best of education to the children and youth who become the beneficiaries of our mission, so that they grow up to be what God wants them to be. So we are indeed equal partners in this gigantic task and noble mission of education. As I was asked to give a message to you all on this auspicious occasion and started thinking about it, I received a video clip through the social media just day before yesterday, and I thought that it was truly God sent. And I knew then and there that I had to share it with you all. This video that I received is of a 6-year-old girl, Tiana by name, giving advice to her mom and dad. It's so touching and so meaningful. If you haven't seen this before, I think it's something that you should really see it and be inspired by it. So let's watch this together for a couple of minutes.
Yes.
Try not to be that high up to be friends. I want everything to be low. Okay?
Okay.
Just try friends. I don't want you and my dad to be replaced in me again. I want you and my dad to be placed and settled and be friends. I'm not trying to be me. I just want everyone to be friends. And if I can be nice, I think all of us can be nice too. I'm not trying to be mean, but I'm trying to do my best in my heart. Nothing else than that. I want you, mom, my dad, everyone to be friends. I want everyone to be smiling. there's a little bit of person and we will eat them, then no one will ever be here. Only the monsters in our place. We need everyone to be a person. Everyone. Including me and my mom. Everyone. I just want everything to be settled down. Nothing else. I just want everything to be good as possible. Nothing else.
Thank you, Jenna. Come with me, Mama Juju. I love you.
I love you too.
I'm sure you must have found that very touching, very inspiring. In fact, after watching that for the first time, I was just saying to myself, my goodness, what maturity, what wisdom. And that too from a six-year-old kid. I'm sure the great majority of you here are not going through a rough patch as Tiana's parents were. But the message that she offers is valid and precious for all of us. Of course, for parents in the first place, but for all of us too. She says it's important to have friendly relationships with all, in the family especially. That we should not be mean to each other. We should not become monsters. That we need to settle down to our mean heights, down to short heights. Especially to the middle level, the heart level. The education of a child starts from within the family, and that's quite obvious. The loving atmosphere at home is what will educate the child most of all. It's to highlight this truth that our rector major, our superior general, gave the entire Don Bosco family a motto to propagate and to practice in this current year, 2017. And the motto was, we are a family. Every home, a school of life and love. We are a family. Every home, a school of life and love. Every family becomes the first place where love and acceptance is taught, where education to love takes place. And then this education to love is carried over from family to the school. The school becomes a second home to your children. Here in the school, this school too, our primary goal is to inculcate the capacity to love in our students. Don Bosco wanted to be so. For him, education meant teaching the youngster to be God-filled, faithful persons, and to be good and honest citizens. I remind my moral science students time and again that moral science is the first and the most important subject that they study in this school. I tell them that if you do not imbibe and live by moral values, no matter how much education you get by studying the science and art subjects, it will be an education that is futile, an education that is practically useless. The goal of our education is to make our students good human beings in the first place. Human beings who are capable of loving. This, I think, is the message that Tiana was trying to give. That we all need to be persons with the heart. To be persons of the heart. Compassionate, loving, and smiling. If this is ensured in the family in the first place, the rest of the education will follow suit with success, I'm sure. This evening, also on behalf of the parents, I would like to express our appreciation and gratitude to all those who are collaborating in this mission of ours, starting with the principal of the school, Reverend Father Nobi George, who is truly committed to this cause and spends all his time and energy in very creative ways to make this happen here in the school. The Vice Principal, Reverend Father Thomas Subhash Gomes, the Bursar, and primary in charge, Reverend Father P.K. Joy, Reverend Sister Philo Augustine, coordinator of the primary school, the managing committee members, and other fathers and brothers of this institution to deserve our gratitude for working together enthusiastically and with zest in bringing out the best from the children. No less are the efforts put in by our dedicated teachers as well as our non-teaching staff. Thanks to one and all for your unique and committed role in carrying out the mission of Don Bosco, the mission of education to love. May Almighty God help all of us to create this civilization of love. Lastly, and not in the least, a big thank you to Father Principal and the entire team of Don Bosco Bandel, the teachers and the other staff, and especially the heroes of this evening, our students, for preparing this enchanting evening we are going to witness over here. Lots of hard work has been put in here, as you will see soon. So, wish you all a very pleasant and enjoyable evening. Thank you, and God bless you all.
That preach the word of the universe, the goal and meaning of life, the reason of existence, answers to all but none. It is the prayer that adores the presence of the divinity in all the elements of nature. Ladies and gentlemen, we present you the prayer dance, symbolizing the higher realm of spirituality, the cause of you, ladies and gentlemen, presenting Mangalam.
Agni Mangalam, Agni Mangalam, Vayu Mangalam.
is a nurturer, caregiver, protector, and when necessary, the destroyer. She loves as fiercely as she hates. She is the truest manifestation of the supreme power and the core essence of the whole cosmos at its roots. The skate canvases, the current scenario where tradition is being pushed to the edge, cursed out of the social mainstream by the monolithic monster, urbanization. The skate also subtly etches a mark through his take on womanhood and the current problems the world is facing at large, the decimation of Mother Nature and spiritualism. The dawn of power, a Mother Nature, a goddess Durga, in the heart of every mother, symbolizing unfathomable power and strength. The reborn, the transformation, the transcendence of power and strength. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting before you a sketch by the class 9, reincarnation.
I understand, but make sure you don't fall into any danger. You are dealing with thugs. They can go to any extent to get the land.
Yes, we can't afford to do that because that is exactly what they want. They want to frighten us. God knows what lies ahead. But think twice before taking any decision.
Yes, the puja committee field. Yes, 4 mahoganies. Okay, done. Guys, Mr. Bhandari has agreed to the deal and his men will start chopping up those trees after the pujas.
And what's the deal?
15 lakhs for those trees.
Oh, a handsome one.
Chote, this is just the beginning.
And if we are able to take hold of that land and hand it to our boss, then another big deal is awaiting us.
We have to capture it. By hook or by crook, we can't let go such a huge deal. They don't come across every day.
But will those people give us their land so easily?
They won't. We have to snatch it from them.
And who is there to stop us? Those timid puja committee boys or those bunch of old haggards?
And if they move the court?
After all the threatening, they won't have the guts to do so. By the way, it's time we give them another warning.
Ramesh, what is all this I'm hearing? Are you really after that land?
This is a part of business.
What kind of business do you think you are doing? This is unethical.
Ma, you better stay out of this. You won't understand.
I don't want to, but what you are doing is unjust. The young and old, go there to relax. Those poor hawkers make some business in the evenings. A puja is held there every year. That field is a community asset. You have no right to destroy it.
Enough of the philosophical thoughts. Keep them with you. Your philosophy won't fetch us money, and the deal I'm after will change our lives forever. And then you won't have to work as a maid servant anymore.
Ramesh, I would better work as a maid servant all my life than take your fetched money. You will never be able to enjoy the money that you earn by hurting other sentiments and causing distress to them.
Don't do this. Leave the deal. Don't talk like a fool. I am not going to let go of this deal. No way.
Ramesh, come and have your dinner. Why are you venting your anger on the food? How can you keep me hungry?
Yeah, leave that there.
that. Moreover, what you are doing is very foolish. Ramesh and his gang will demolish everything. Once they get to know that you are putting out a pandal.
Maybe, but we want it either.
All your efforts will go in vain. You should have agreed to the deed.
Listen, if you don't want to help us, fine. But at least don't discourage us and add to our woes.
Today is Chuturthi and we have to complete the pandal today.
And by tomorrow evening, the idols will have to be placed here.
Well, I am thinking, now what will be Ramesh's next step?
Talk of the devil, and the devil comes. We warned you many a time not to make any arrangement here, and you go about putting up the pandal. Do you want to show your bravery?
Till now, we have been requesting you. But if you don't make it to us, we'll be forced to resort to other means. Would you like that?
Listen guys, this is our field and the society benefits from it. We are not willing to sell it off. Why are you pressurizing us?
Hey, enough! Stop it now! Enough of your lectures. This is the last time we are warning you. Stop all this drama regarding the puja and pull down the pandal. No one will help in putting it up.
Look, we want this land. So it is better you accept our offer or you have to face the consequences.
Hey, stop, stop! Where are you going?
Sorry, Rajada. We won't work here anymore. Our life is very dear to us
and we can't afford to risk it for you.
I told you this would happen.
Worse than me.
become afraid of your threats? Hey, come on! Pull on everything!
This is her. She's the real mother. One who stands up against all forms of evil, against what is wrong and represses it. She is the positive power that society is in want of, and that power is inherent in all of us. She is the manifestation of Mother Nature, our creator, who is so loving and caring, yet so powerful. Come on everybody, let's all worship her. Play the harp, blow the conch shell, come on.
Age stands on its name, its fame, for the contribution, the dedicated and sincere servitude of some distinguished personalities who have transformed and added to the inlaid philosophy of this very institution. The people who have put their tiring hard work in molding the structure and making it more elegant, diversified, strengthened, and ever living. This evening, we take great honor in felicitating the jubilarians who have laid their committed service in the betterment of this institution of this name, Don Bosco Bandung. I now invite on Reverend Father Rector and Reverend Father Principal to come up on the stage and felicitate the jubilarians of this year as we celebrate their 25th year of profound unmanned service. Now I'd like to call upon the jubilarians on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome them with a thunderous round of applause. Ma'am Lupi Kapoor, Sir Vinay Prakash Devedi, Ma'am Kanchan Malash Shaw, and Sir Santosh Tirki. Ma'am Lipika Bose, a strict disciplinarian, a perfectionist, and an idealist. The teachers who love teaching teach children to love learning. And that is exactly how we define Ma'am Lipika. Ma'am Bose, a storehouse of knowledge, has instilled in all of us a fragment of curiosity. She's the one who has planted the seeds of knowledge. Her classes that have sprinkled water on these seeds of inquisitiveness and has taught us to dream big. A teacher whose classes we eagerly wait for, ranging from literature to linguistics, the episodes were also times so very interesting. Ma'am, today we commemorate your 25th year of utmost dedicated service on this solemn occasion. Perhaps these words are not enough to repay you with all our gratefulness. The students you taught and made what they are today are not here to see you and express their gratitude. So, ma'am, on behalf of the student community of Don Bosco School, Bandung, we express our gratefulness today. Thank you, ma'am, for all the instruction. Thank you for the encouragement. Thank you for the influence. Thank you for the inspiration. Thank you for the knowledge and thank you for you being you, ma'am. Ma'am Kanchan Malash Shaw, a very patient, simple, highly cooperative teacher, Ma'am Kanchan Malash has always been a lenient and forgiving person. With the immense knowledge in her subject, She has always tried to fulfill all her responsibilities. We wish ma'am good health and blessings for all her future endeavors. Sir Vinay Prakash Dwivedi, sir has always been a man of few words and more of action. An extremely dedicated and sincere teacher, sir has also been very helpful and ever ready to take on any responsibilities. He has also been a former and such a present personality, and we pray for his well-being as he completes 25 years of service in this institution. Mr. Santosh Tirki, be it at the early hours of the dawn or the late hours of the dusk, he has always been there for us, always making us teach and reach the allotted place on the absolute right hour. We thank you for your wonderful service and wish you all for your future endeavors. I now request Reverend Father Principal and Reverend Father Rector to present our token of appreciation to this respected Jubilarian on this very special day.
May I now call upon Ma'am Libika Bose to speak on behalf of the Jubilarians and describe how the journey has been this far.
A very good evening to one and all present here. Reverend Father Rector, Father C.J. Anthony, Reverend Father Principal, Father Nobi K. George, Reverend Father Vice Principal, Father Thomas Combs, Reverend Father Bursar, Father P.K. Joy, Fathers, Brothers, Guests of Honor, my colleagues and my dear parents. I feel honored and privileged to have this opportunity to speak on behalf of all the Jubilarians. I extend my heartfelt thanks to all my former rectors, principals and vice principals for their constant support and guidance. Special thanks to Father Michael Pettikill, Father Thomas Combs, Father Benny Isaac, Father V.C. George, Father Joseph Pettikill, Father V.T. Jones, Father K.V. Matthew, Father Sibby Varikal, and Father K.V. James for helping me to grow as a teacher and making me what I am today. I feel blessed to be a part of this Salesian family where I have always received love, compassionate care and empathy. I am grateful to God for making me an instrument of molding young minds and giving me this opportunity to be close to innocent hearts. Perhaps Jubilee is the time to remind ourselves of our mission and contribution to life. I am deeply grateful to Father Nobi K. George for arranging this grand felicitation and making us feel so special. It is a pleasure to work under his guidance. I express my sincere gratitude to Reverend Father Rector for his words of encouragement at times of dejection and weakness. A very special thank you to my first principal, Father Thomas Combs, for giving me an opportunity to be a member of this family and instilling in me the skills of a teacher. I extend sincere thanks to my colleagues and support staff for their love, care, cooperation and guidance. I thank you, dear parents, for believing in me and entrusting your children to my care, making my life more meaningful. I thank my students for being patient with me and humbly accepting my instructions and corrections. Once again, I thank all the members of this family for being so good and kind. Everything in life is temporary, but memories remain. Thank you, dear Father Principal, for creating this memory for us. My prayers and best wishes for all of you for a wonderful life ahead. Thank you.
A school stands recognized, revered for its students and pupils. The students who put their sincere hard work in academics bringing the institution, the pride, the honor and glory it always stood for, keeping the bar always raised. We today award the students who have been the icon of academic excellence in this year and have shown exemplary performance in the field of academics. May I call upon Reverend Father Principal Father Nobi George for awarding the students. For ICEC, we have Ashutosh Kumar Singh topping the list in school as well as in the district and a third ranking state with a flying percentage of 98.60. I would like to request his parents to collect the award on his behalf. May I also call upon Reverend Father Rector for giving the other awards of the day. For IC, we have Pramit Banerjee from the Commerce stream with a score of 96%. Pramit, you are requested to come and receive the award. We also have Shauna Sinha Roy from the Humanities stream with also a score of 96%. Thank you, fathers. Ladies and gentlemen, can we have another huge round of applause for this young, bright face in the school to be portrayed? School strike. Father Principal, you requested to stay back for a while. We have a very special prize this year. We have the Kindness Award 2017, and I would request Father Principal to carry on with the proceedings for this award.
The year 2017 saw a special award being given to a very special person. We have been looking for in a very special way to award someone who is doing an act of kindness. We were looking for random deeds who would probably not get recognized, who would probably not get, let us say, appreciated elsewhere. From all the students, parents and teachers and all connected with our school, we looked for contestants in this category. The award is called Share Kindness Award. I would like to now announce to you this special prize goes to Ma'am Devika Shaw Das. Please appreciate that I call upon Ma'am to come to receive this prize. Is she anywhere? I do not know. Yes, please come. I would like to request Father Rector to hand over this appreciation and ask ma'am how she feels at this time. Can you tell us what you did, how you deserve this award?
Good evening, everyone. Actually, I was myself not aware of this. Sports day, junior sports day, I was on my way to school. Father asked me to come a bit early because cricket tournament selection was going on. And on the way, I met a child, 8 years old. Parents had sent her out to get sweets. So she was in her cycle and she came in front of her auto. The auto hit her. She fell. She got hurt. I was in a hurry because I had to leave school by 10. And you know, we are very punctual about all this. But then I had to call father up to say that I'll be a bit late. I took her to the chemist over there, gave her medication, called her parents. So as soon as the parents came, I was back to school. So I had to thank father because he allowed me to be late that day. Thank you.
It's very special because she came 15 minutes late to school, and generally our teachers don't come. and a child received attention on the road. This is a very special prize that we have recognized, and I'm sure this is going to encourage. The certificate says Share Kindness Award 2017. This is to thank someone for doing something kind. Don Bosco School Panel acknowledges, appreciates and promotes deeds of kindness. We firmly believe that kindness is the greatest gift we can give to someone. And the recipient of 2017 DBB Share Kindness Award is Ms. Devika Das Shah for the extraordinary kindness exhibited 2nd December 2017.
Talking of your stature, gratitude, Tenzin, there's no better answer than action. Dear parents, it's impossible to repay your contribution in our lives. Your care, your nurturing, your warmth that has made us grow. Be it a gesture of gratitude or through any song or a grand event, the contribution is never repaid. No words, no adjectives will be enough to comprehend how much we love and care for you. So on this very special day, we have a very special dedication to you, dear parents, presenting before you the Don Bosco School Panel Choir Group with the song, You're the Number One for Me. And yes, parents, you have always been the number one for us.
Thank you.
Music, the highest form of all arts, a form of art that defies all laws of nature. Past all memes, all metaphors, music has no language but the language of music itself. An art form that drives human thinking, the instincts to a different realm, pushes the power of creativity, intermix with skill, creation and composition, resulting in sheer magic. Ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time in the musical history of Don Bosco School Pandal, a very special instrumental performance. The students, past pupils, parents and teachers of this school have come together and collaborated to produce this melodious and magnanimous composition, ranging from the genres of the late 60s to today, right from Eastern classical to country rock, and with a tinge bit of nostalgia, ladies and gentlemen, Teri Yaad Saath Hai. On the vocals, we have Veerpatit Bhattacharya, on the keyboard, Riddhiman Ganguly. On the octopad, we have Sir Shurjit Powell, and on the percussion, Mr. Madan Chakrabarti and Mr. Devashish Mukherjee. On the glass harmonica, we have Mr. Shoipal Sengupta. On the bass guitar, Roshan Jacob. On the harmonica, Bhimashish Giri. On ukulele, Samrit Das. And on the lead guitar, Indrani Chatterjee. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome them with a thunderous round of applause. Thank you.
transformation through charity and service, with a dire effort to reinstate love and peace. The symbol of charity and motherly affection was and ever will be our Mother Teresa of Kolkata, the guardian of the poor and the needy, the pioneer for a change in humanity. Ladies and gentlemen, our dance performance as a tribute to Mother Teresa, put up by the class lemons.
And benediction. Mother Teresa, an inspiration, a savior, a parent, and a guide to many, has become the symbol of peace, humanity, and hope in this era plunged in violence and hatred. She served humanity for 6 long decades. Tens of thousands of Catholics from around the world attended the canonization to celebrate the mother, who was rightly called the saint of the gutters during her lifetime. With this, we bow in supplication to, as we humbly recognize Mother Teresa's servitude to this world and nation in parenting the parentless and being God's incarnation of humanity for many. This small item presented by the students of Don Bosco Bandel is just a mere attempt to celebrate the years of parenthood and to stand with those who have lost the privilege and blessing of having their parents with them. On this day, when we celebrate the efforts put in by our parents to make our lives better, the Teresas of our life, the one who stood beside us as our guide, a philosopher, a teacher, and a friend, we today express our gratitude towards them.
You make me smile.
Reverend Father Principal, Father Novi George, to present the annual school report for the year 2017.
A warm good evening to one and all present in this August gathering on the 2nd of December 2017. When Don Bosco School remembers and expresses tokens of appreciation and engages in showing heartfelt gratitude to those whom it admires most. Most respected and loving Father Rector, the parents of Don Bosco School Band wish you all a pleasant evening. To continue with my report, I'd like rather go down so that I can be faster.
We have wonderful parents and Father Rector here. I would like to wish all of you a very happy Rector's and Parents' Day. The school is governed by its governing body, that is constituted of Reverend Father Provincial, Father Norman Gomes, Father Vincent Mondal, its Economa, and Father Joseph Pauria, its Vice Provincial. We have in our community here Father Rector, Reverend Father E.J. Anthony, Father Thomas Gomes, its Vice Principal, former Principal for many years here, Father P.K. Joy, primary in charge, and Bursa. The Salesian staff who joined in the year 2017 June. We have Father Dorfman Mondol, Father Bertie Fernandez, Brother Chaco, Brother Simon, Brother Feroz, Brother Vijay. Of course, myself too. We welcome this year several new teachers, Ma'am Shama Pariyar, Ranita Batavia, and Pranamita. In the senior section and in the junior section, Martha and Rashmi. The managing committee of the school is constituted of Father Sunil Kiro, the president of the managing committee, who is also the principal of Don Bosco School, Lilima. Father Novi George, vice president, Father E.J. Anthony, secretary, Father P.K. Joy, Sister Regina, who is the principal of Auxilium School, Bandit, Father Thomas Holmes, Mona Lisa, Sister Philo, Sir Kaushik, Mr. Sandeep, and Mr. Subrata, the members of the managing committee. Thank you, dear members of the managing committee, for helping us and supporting us in our ventures. The junior section teachers there all on smile on their faces. 30 teachers in the junior section, and we have 43 teachers in the senior section here at Bandel. The office staff consisting of Azad, Kaushik, Pinky, Tarun, Abhishek and Sukhando and the support staff down there. Thank you, dear office staff, especially to Azad and Sukhando who are always my right and left. Thank you so much. The jubilarians, we already felicitated them, Ma'am Lipika, Ma'am Panjanmala and Sir Divedi. Also, Mr. Santosh Tirki, congratulations and thank you for your dedicated service for the past 25 years. God bless you. Yes, you recognize him. This is none other than the former principal. You didn't have an occasion to thank him. Can you please thank him with a round of applause and thank him sufficiently on this occasion? We were not called on the farewell day for Father K.V. James. I would like to extend a big thanks. Thank you so much, dear Father James, for what you have been, for what you have done. And Don Bosco Bandel will ever remember your contributions. Thank you so much, wherever you are. God bless you. We thank Father Anandraj, the administrator of our school, till May 2017. Father has been transferred. Father Albert Kuchu was the Dean of Studies and in his place Father Dorpon has come. Thank you and God bless. Yes, Ma'am Tasim, who is present here, Thank you, ma'am, for your dedicated service for many years in this school. She was my teacher too. And she retired in the month of July 2017. God bless you in your retired life and visit us often at Bangalore. The ICC highlights, we have already heard the students who got first, second, third, etc. About 90% we had 56 students, and the others you can see 51, 34, 33 and 14. Total 188 appeared for ICC. Congratulations, and I thank in a special way the teachers of our school who worked very hard behind it together with the parents of our school. Thank you and God bless you. The ISC results, we had 90% at about 23 students, about 80% 31, then 14, 13 and 4. Total 85 students have participated in this examination. The topper, Ashutosh Kumar Singh, made us all proud with 98.6, and that was something to be proud of. Yes. Next we had ISC toppers, Pramit, who is present here. Congratulations, Pramit, and we wish you all best of luck. Shaunak here, present here, and thank you for coming this evening, both of you. You really made us proud from the ISC category. I should also receiving the Mamraj Agarwal Puraskar from the none other than the governor, honorable governor of our state. The student has it in its enrollment. Senior section had 1,110 students, junior section 930 students. The academic committee who ably assist the principal in its academic matters. First semester we had Ma'am Nilanjana and Ma'am Kanchanwala. In the second semester right now we have Sir Nirmal Ghosh and Sir Divedi. Both of them are really doing hard work. Thank you, sir, for your contribution. The discipline committee, who ably assists the principal in all discipline matters of the school. In the first semester, we have Sir Jacob, Sir Anantho, Washik, and Ma'am Shampa. In the second semester, right now, we have N.D. Jacob, sir, Anita Lahiri, Devika, ma'am, and Shampa Sharpagar. Thank you for helping us with the discipline and seeing to the discipline of the school. Co-curricular activities, we have Ma'am Shomba and Ma'am Tingul Ghosh. These are the four committees who, help us together with the houses. The next is the four houses of the school. Red House, in charge Sir Apurbo. Green House, Ma'am Benapalit. Blue House, Tepok Mandol. And Yellow House, Ma'am Balanga Borel. These are the four in charges who help us in the houses. Next. The Student Council, who ably assist in running the school is teachers and the management, headed by Harsh Sharma, who also received our gratitude yesterday in the school. Prefect Pinaki, Vice Prefect, and Rajeshri Chaturji, Assistant Prefect. The other names are there, not going to read. The Student Council members present there, you can see different houses there, have captains and vice captains. The school year began on the 3rd of April. I will go rather quickly this next. The May Day celebration on the 1st of May. The feast of Dhanisami on the 6th of May. The investiture ceremony on the 14th of July. We had for 15th of July Gospel Expressions, where 19 schools had participated in various activities, where our students got chance to participate and excel in many things. The Bhakta Jayanti celebrated on the 16th of this year had a very special flavor because it was also an occasion for 1992 ICC batch to come back to the school to play a football match, friendly match, where Father Provincial himself was present. You can see Father Provincial there. And it was a wonderful match. Some of the alumni present here also were playing on that occasion. We had a prayer service in honor of Don Bosco and praised and thanked God for the gift of St. Don Bosco for all of us. We had science exhibition immediately after the first semester exams. since the principal of Auxiliary was the champion of the occasion. The Children's Day was celebrated also this year with much warmth and mirth. There were a lot of celebration activities. Children had very many games and participations. The past peoples of the school, especially Sandeep and Group, really did us make us happy that day. And we can see the singing there. The past people saw it, the decorations, the singing and activities, and it was a wonderful way back home for them on that occasion. Thank you, past people, for your contribution. On Children's Day, we also had the football and other games. Continue. The sports day of the primary section, that is junior section, was celebrated on the last week, just 25th of November. I would like to express my gratitude to Father Joy, the primary in charge, and Sister Fidelis coordinator for really doing a wonderful job. The honorable district magistrate was the chief guest for the occasion. Rectors and Parents Day was celebrated yesterday, the first day of the celebration. And today the second day, where you are all being seated and you are photographed. It will be coming at the next edition. The co-curricular activities, I'm not going to read all of them. You have in your diaries, and some more are added. Storytelling quiz as a competition where all our students participate and perform and come up and develop their talents. Next slide. We had the Bosco Utsav in Lidwa, Bosco Fest in Park Circus, Bosco Expression here, then many other programs. Please continue. I don't want to read all the programs where our students are going. Right now our students are participating in a program for science exhibition in Birla Technological Museum, where they are hosting some programs there. Please continue the next. Seminars and workshops, just I would like to say some seminars we organized for our students, class 10, 11, 12, various animations. Class 9 had teenage issues and psychosocial counseling by Anubhav Group. Next, class 8 had Siddharth Sangha Roy, IITIMX, who did a workshop. And for class 7, we had a workshop which was also appreciated. Workshop for group dynamics conducted by Father Augustine from Kathmandu. We had also our students participate in the judicious use of internet organized by the ASI CMS Bengal chapter. And the students in return came back to the school. I have seen in Telegraph and other newspapers about this and inform about this use and misuse of social media. Next. Our teachers too participated, principal himself and attended various meetings and updating programs. I'm not going into all that on ASIC, INAC, CBCI, AHS, West Bengal, let's say DICE of West Bengal, so many things. Students, teachers especially participated in updating programs organized by the ICC Council in its office in Kolkata. Next. We had the parents-teachers meeting class 9, 10, 11 and 12. Many parents who are present here are of class 7 and 8. Your meetings are scheduled. It will be made known to you in due time. There were wonderful exchanges, and we have benefited from that, and your children are really benefiting from that, the result of such meetings. Thank you for all the participation and your active collaboration. Next. The students were awarded many awards. We have displayed them on the notice boards and the sheets. Thank you, and congratulations to all our boys and to teachers who prepared them. Please proceed. Yes, so I would like to say something about security services in the school. With the modern facilities, we have installed CCTV cameras in all areas. I'm sure the children have told you that they are being watched in different corners. From the gate till they go back to the gate, we have the CCTV cameras. And not only this, we have the staff who have been trained, who are always present in various locations. They are always under the watchful eye of our teachers or non-teaching staff. I must tell you, they really deserve a lot of appreciation. Every moment the children in the school are attended and are protected. You can be happy, is it not? Thank you. Next. The school will have its new chemistry lab, which is coming up soon. And I would like to thank Father Bersam, who is seeing to the completion of this job, and it will serve us or serve our science faculty and its work better. Thank you. We have approached the Tata Class 8 for giving us solutions to our classrooms, and we already signed an agreement. Within few days they are doing the book mapping, and then the classes will be held based on the textbooks that we are using. That's the benefit of Tata Class, and it will be coming soon, maybe within 20 days time. One day we will be giving holiday to our teachers, to our students, for training our teachers. So please understand, in this connection we need to train our teachers so that they can use it effectively. Next. Some programs that are coming up. On Monday, December 4th, pre-board examination for ISC 2018 begins. Inter-house cricket tournament for senior section. That day is a study leave or holiday for our students. But those who are in cricket tournament and those who like to come to watch, you are welcome. Not a compulsory attendance day on that day. But for the teachers, there is no holiday. We see how this is the dedication of our teachers, and we are not giving a holiday to our teachers on that day. Educational trip for class 11 is scheduled in this month. Scout camp at Koti. There is also a jubilee in Don Bosco School Deliver, which will be taking place end of this month, where also auxiliary school students are participating. These are some of the events that are coming up. I would like to, at this time, say an extended group of our school in its Past People's Association. When Ajay and Kosmik, they have been doing a wonderful job, and then Rajat, Rahul, Vaitayo, they have been doing several things. Next slide. And just so you can see, one of the activities that are conducted here, there was an eye checkup that was organized here. They also did other services. I'm not going into all the details. Congratulations and thanks to our Past People's Alumni Association, represented by several people, and many in the balcony there are boys who are now members and who are going to join. Thank you, boys, for coming today. Social outreach program, have participate. Next. We thank you, dear parents, for your collaboration to raise 2,86,000 to contribute to BoscoNet, who in turn is helping the flood victims of Nepal, the plains of Nepal, which experienced severe flooding this year. Thank you. Thank you, dear parents, for supporting us in this venture. As I conclude, my sincere appreciation and gratitude to all parents of DBB 2017. We know how much you esteem our institution, how much you support us in all our endeavors, how much you expect us to work hard, always giving us an honest challenge for improvements which are inevitable and time-bound. Thank you so much, dear parents. Next. The ISC examinations, we have 184 students in class 10 and 82 students for ISC. Wish you best of luck and to our candidates. Once again, wish you happy practice and Parents' Day. Enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your seats, for it's now time for the grand event that we have been patiently and eagerly waiting for. It's time that outlaw gentleman in Lincoln green dress to come up and narrate his adventurous story and how he battled the rich to become the savior of the needy. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Robin Hood and his band of members taking us in an exhilarating ride through the woods of Nottingham, with the sheriff and his kingsmen chasing behind him. Ladies and gentlemen, let us gear up for this wonderful play, Robin Hood and his Merry Men.
man. I trust to do the job. Honestly and with fairness. I thus pass my duty to Rupert.
Pure and free, but I was born in luxury. my name is Love It Up.
It is! Hooray! Hooray!
And life is really, really good when you are Robin Hood.
It is! Hooray! Hooray!
I placed my child outside the law. I stole it from rich and gave to poor. And even though it started fights, I took to very deep green tights. I wore a cap and chopped my head. I hung a cock piece, you know that. I vowed to always fight for good. And so was born your Robin Hood. For my name is Robin Hood.
Of Sherwood, I have come to know that the poor are suffering so. The sheriff played the villainy and raised the taxes. My dear merrymen, let's march to Nottingham and see what vexes the villagers and do our very best to put the things at rest.
Let's do it! Hooray for the people! To Nottingham!
The nation is divided, as you will plainly see. The rich in all their riches, the poor in poverty. King Richard has gone to a faraway land, and justice is left in the brave outlaw's hands.
Thank you.
gives it a fairness that the usual method lacks. First, the gross amount of wages is divided into stages. Then the lowest grade of income pays the highest grade of tax. So, the peasant in the field, my new formulary revealed, will now be tax collector over twice his yearly pay. So he'll work much longer hours to improve his fiscal powers.
Where do you expect us to put 100 goats? You're taking all the land.
Goats? G-O-A-T-S. Deputy! You fool! It's clothes, not goats. You need to pay more attention during your spelling program.
Only 100 groats? Oh, Robin, you're worth so much more than that to me.
I've had enough of Robin of Locksley, or Robin Hood as he calls himself now. Stupid name. Why not Harold Helmet or Bertie Bobblehead?
His name is Robin, and he likes a hug, sire.
Why don't you go and offer yourself as a target practice for my archers? No! Come back here! Sorry to say, but I have need of you. I want you to disguise yourself as one of his rabbits and find out about Robin Hood's whereabouts.
I have a cunning plan
to rid myself. Robin, the people's champion. My deputy shall be able to find out about his whereabouts and secret camp. Meanwhile, I'll cut down every tree in the Sherwood Forest, leaving him no place to hide. And that will keep my castle in locks for years. When I have Robin Hood, I will think of some exquisitely painful punishment for him, which will be the star attraction to the party I have planned to celebrate my victory!
Sire, I heard you were looking for a jester.
Indeed, I need to keep a sense of humor with all the stress.
Well, have you heard of the recent GST?
Now what on earth is that?
It's all about you, sire.
Me?
Yes, great sense of taxing.
What? Take him away, you moron! That's criminal!
Oh, yes.
You lot are always complaining about not having any money. So, here's a chance to get 100 groats tax-free. No one interested, today. Well, I'd better start cutting down your precious forest. Tree fellas, please!
I thought there were three fellas, but there were only two!
Tree fellas!
Oh, I understand.
I can see! I'm going to think of some more taxes for you to pay.
Hello! Taxing the fear that
Silence, right! Taxable! The only thing that you tax! That's an excellent idea! I'll work on it. But for now, I'll just double the tax on grain.
Robin Hood will never stand for that!
Anyone found helping that outlaw will suffer a terrible punishment, which I will thoroughly enjoy inflicting!
What are we going to do? You destroy our forest and we won't have any wood.
We can't pay any taxes, and now if we double the tax on grain, we'll starve.
Why did King Richard have to go and fight in the Crusades? Nothing's been the same since he's gone.
I would love to get my hands on that sheriff
when he doesn't have his guards round him?
Why? He's got his guys everywhere.
Guys? I thought Simon was the fireman. Why is the sheriff selling pies? And what sort are they? Shepherd's pies? Or mince pies? Or cottage pies? Or Cumberland pies? Or sausage pies with diced onions and a delicate hint of parsley and sage?
From the town, tucked away in the green, is Robin Hood's band, faithful, honest and keen. They want to see justice honored again, so they hope and they pray and they fight and they train.
forest.
Cheers.
fighting even so far. Now, it's time for the archery contest. May I remind you again to keep hold of all carrier pigeons and that the management takes no responsibility at all for stray arrows landing randomly on body parts. Bring on the contestants. Has it not been exciting so far? Are you enjoying it? Are you enjoying it? Are you enjoying it? Yeah! Here's our first contestant, Bob Bullseye Baxter from Bucklands Beach. That's a little wide of mark, but he will enjoy a nice roast pheasant tonight. Next contestant, please. Geoff the Archer. Now, this boy has a noble approach. You'll find it. But no cheating, Geoff. That's a miss, I think. Is there a doctor in the house? And finally, we have a mystery contestant known only as the Sherwood Sure Shot. In the ball in just a few moments. Come, let's get ready for the ball dance.
Thank you.
in such mean, grasping hands? And what will become of the proud, merry band? The fair lady weeps. Her love's life is at stake. Oh, a sad sight it is to see a heart break.
So, I thought I would make a
done. People of Nottingham, talk to you about the same thing. Enough to eat, a safe, warm place to live in safety.
Reverend Father Vice Principal, Father T.S. Combs, to deliver the vote of thanks.
To an end. So is our program. But we cannot end without thanking people. Dear Reverend Father Rector, our dear beloved parents, and to all well wishers present here. Rector's and Parents' Day is really a very special one, as we have gathered to show love and gratitude and indebtedness to some really special people. John F. Kennedy said once, "We must find time to stop to thank the people who make differences in our lives." Our hearty thanks first goes to our dear Father Rector, on whose shoulder we all shelter. He is Don Bosco among us to guide us and to lead us to our destination. Together with Father Rector are our dear parents, day in and day out, our dear parents really after us, wearing themselves out. Today is the day to show our love and gratitude and thanks to our beloved parents. I take this opportunity to extend our heartfelt thanks to our Father Principal for guiding today's program so very well. We extend our thanks to Father Bursar for being a guiding hand in our material needs, to Father Dorpun and his team for his support and help. We express our warmest thanks to our dear teachers, and especially to them who took to directing and preparing the various items. Also to all those who have been behind them in extending their helping hands. So thank you, dear teachers. I take this opportunity to extend our appreciation to our supporting staff. Thank you for your real support and hard work. Last but not the least, to all well-wishers who have been present to grace our program this evening. So thank you, all of you, for being present here, and God bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the hymn to our Father and Founder, John Bosco.
Thank you.
Times of Bengal, where Bengal theme first appeared in the world.